Nowhere in the world you'll find this experience. Leading business schools in US or Europe, they can come either from private or state funded. Please remember, here everything is funded to IIMs. Fact of life. How can you compare a business school of as big as 108 acres, 200 acres, 300 acres of campus? Standalone business school. Right. Now, how can you compare with an independent business school which is private? AACP norms have been seen, I'm sure you're familiar. 0.5 acres of land should be there to be an institution. You must be knowing that. If it's a mentors. Tell me, how can you get 0.5 acres of land in Bombay? Can you show me 0.5 acres of land in Hyderabad within the city? If it is there, I'm sure there are multiplex already come. No, it doesn't make any sense. Right? And AACP itself doesn't have its own building and land. I tell them as a blind spot. You don't have permanent employees. All of them are contract. And you say you can't have a contract employees in business schools. We'll come to that bit later. No emphasis on research. Now, if an American business school is respected, if an American professor is respected, he is respected only on this discount. And I have a request for industry. You pick up any journal that is published. The authors profusely thank the funding they got from the corporate for the research. In India, Indian corporates are very funny ones. I'm sorry. I said this in several industry bodies, I'll say it here. Right? They think the job is over by paying the tax or by avoiding tax. It is the job of the government to give the funding. Tell me how many universities get funds for research from UGC? Look at it. But no funding for research. Where is the funding for research? Research is like romance. It's a very, very expensive proposition. You need lots of money and muscle power to do research. So is for romance. Next one, please. Look at the profile of students we get. I told you, India is a very unique country. No respectable business school will allow a guy to do his master's program in business administration if he had no work experience. Take it from me. But for us, it's BA. It is fully green with moss. Right? So, the kind of students you get. Now, you might ask a question, what about IIMs? IIMs, what do? We take a large number of 1.85 lakhs people, we do some churning and take the top one, thinking it's a queen, it could be flawed. We don't want that. But corporates believe that some of you students are the best. We don't question them because it suits us. I mean, very candid with you. Like, what is the profile of students you get in a standalone business school somewhere on the way between Anakapalli and Visakhapatnam? What is the profile of students you expect? You may get students from, you know, Tripura and Northeast, thinking that there's something here. By the time they realize there's nothing here, the course is over. It takes time for them to understand. What are the profile of activities? Predominantly teaching. Very few institutions have a training opportunity. Please remember, it requires a different kind of a command of subject and orientation to make sense to a corporate guy who had work experience. You can't fool around telling him Maslow's theory, Hitchberg, Masner, Snederman, Patricia King Smith was my classmate in America. Corporate guy will ask, sir, this guy is not working. He took retirement on the date of appointment. Tell me, how do I motivate him? Straightforward question. No, none of your motivation theories with a PowerPoint, with animations, will help. Training, one advantage. Research, what research? There is no research at all. Consulting, very, very little and fine in terms of consulting. Right? Look at the profile of teachers. On 22 contingency table, you have a qualified and competent. Obviously. Not qualified, but not competent. Make him a director. Why not? Right. Look at the candidate. Now, thanks to technology, if you can go to some interesting websites, there is MIT Open Classware. Including the PowerPoint presentations of the professor, teaching notes, learning material, everything is available. In corporate, there is something called copyright. In academics, you don't have copyright, it is right to copy. Here's copy. corporate demands. If corporates don't know, let them know through consulting. You tell them what are the changes. That's a consulting opportunity. Once you know what it is changed, then you can do it. It really happens. Right? Also remember, there is no point in leaving Delhi University. Tell me, what prevented that professor to add on those themes which are of a contemporary relevance?
Sir, first of all, is it true that the
Doesn't matter.
What are your observations? Leave it in that.
No, the point
I
is.
I think it's not correct.
That's okay.
Last 20 years, it has been.
Sir, we have changed. What have we changed? We changed the founder. We changed the founder. Shall I speak about university system, sir? I'm from university. I'm not like one of those IIM professors who have fallen from America. No. I am 100% here. I have worked with 4 universities, Jawaharlal Nehru University, Usmani University, Bayrupur University, Agra University. And I am very proud that I am a university. Whether you are proud or not, my colleagues are proud or not, doesn't matter. I am very proud. The point I am saying is, even if there is a change, tell me what is the change. You change according to the change in MIT. Boston, Cincinnati. Materials, are they dated or updated? Tell me, why are you forcing a student to understand a Maslow's motivation theory? You talked about content, materials. Not that there are no books by Indian authors, but most of the Indian authors' books are nothing but customized, made cheap to an Indian student. You know this? You take a book, you pick up a book on marketing management. It is nothing but straight away taken from Philip Kotler. You know, Charles becomes Chalamaya, Rams become Ramaya. The same bloody case. It is serving a purpose. A professor can say that I have written 5 books. You have to respect for his copying of it. Right? Is it theoretical or pragmatic? What is the point in telling a chap that you have to maintain 8 subsidiary books and accountants? We don't maintain account at all in India. What are we talking about?
Sir, I think.
No question.
We maintain more than one account.
Depending on which is the agency. Right? Method. Is it teacher-centric or student-centric? Fundamental problem we have is most of a business school education is teacher-centric. It is not student-centric. We don't want to realize what the student wants, which he may not know. Next, please. This is another toughest challenges for nascent business schools. Let me concentrate. Your location. ISB at one time was supposed to be, I don't know how many of you know this. When the committee said that you Hyderabad did not have connectivity, international connectivity. We wanted to ship it to Phuket. The reason being, state government of Andhra Pradesh was willing to put 16-lane road from Kuppam to Bangalore, and Bangalore had international connectivity. Ambience. Ambience becomes more important. Right? For a student, he is highly impressed by your website and your brochure. After he joins, you say this is a virtual organization. This is our vision and this is our mission. We are going to achieve all these things, provided people like you come and get cheated by us. Obvious. Connectivity, what is this connectivity we are talking about? If you think of a campus, you cannot get a campus within the city. Unfortunately, in India, when we think of an education institution, we think of a huge campus. Majority of the first year budget goes in building the compound wall for the entire campus. Right? Infrastructure, classrooms, library, computing. You know, several business schools tell me, we have Wi-Fi in place. I ask them, how many hotspots you have? He doesn't understand what is a hotspot. I said, at least Bluetooth is in place. No, sir, I have bad tooth. We give all our students a laptop. Kiska bapka paisa. Are you giving it free? No. It is by, you know, bulk buy. And what do the students, they do? Poor fellows, they say, first they learn how to play solitaire. No, the fact of life. Solitaire, sir. Because it's always lonely on the top. He's preparing himself for a CEO's job by learning solitaire. Right? Now look at visible and credible faculty. I'll give you a solid example.
Something which we have to learn from elsewhere in the world. Stephen Covey did not walk into classroom from the last 17 years. Stephen Covey, you heard his name? But the university retains him because he brings tremendous amount of reputation for that university. At one time, Stephen Covey's book was lying on the tables of secretaries, additional secretaries, joint secretaries, deputy secretaries in the Secretariat of Andhra Pradesh. It has become a big status symbol to put that book on the table. Right? Are they credible faculty? I'll tell you something interesting. Only in India you say, I'm from Usmania, I'm from IIM. If you look at a typical American student, he says, I'm trained by John Kenneth Galbraith. They quote a teacher's name, not a university name. Please understand. Right? Now, biggest problem that you have is retention of faculty. Now, there are two ways of looking at it. IIM Lucknow. I'm talking about IIM Lucknow. There was a question in the parliament recently, which was a stalled question. In the last 2 years, 29 out of 52 faculty members left IIM Lucknow. And our parliamentarians showed grave concern for it. A stalled question means a sponsored question. You know what's a sponsored question? Somebody paid to the parliamentarian to ask that question. Retention of faculty is a big problem. You know why? Those faculty you want them to leave, they will never leave. And those faculty you want them to stay, they will not stay. Fact of life. Credibility in systems and procedures. If you think Rahul Indian Institute of Medical Sciences is respected as an organization, if IITs are respected, if IIMs are respected, only for one reason. Our methods may be crazy. Our methods may be easy in terms of admission. But fact of the life, even... Why? Now, please look at one important thing. It is divided between IIMs and rest of the country. Nowhere in the world you will find this experience. Leading business schools in US or Europe, they can come either from private or state-funded. Please remember, here, everything is funded to IIMs. Fact of life. How can you compare a business school of as big as 108 acres, 200 acres, 300 acres of campus? Standalone business school. Right. Now, how can you compare with an independent business school which is great? AACD norms have you seen, I'm sure you're familiar. 0.5 acres of land should be there to be an institution. You must be knowing that if it's a Mentos. Tell me, how can you get 0.5 acres of land in Bombay? Can you show me 0.5 acres of land in Hyderabad within the city? If it is there, I'm sure there is a multiplex already come. No, it doesn't make any sense. Right? And AACD itself doesn't have its own building and land. I tell them as a blind spot. You don't have permanent employees. All of them are contract. And you say you can't have a contract employees in business schools. We'll come to that a little later. No emphasis on research. Now, if an American business school is respected, if an American professor is respected, he is respected only on this discount. And I have a request for industry. You pick up any journal that is published. The authors profusely thank the funding they got from the corporate for the research. In India, Indian corporates are very funny terms, I'm sorry. I said this in several industry bodies, I say it here. Right? They think the job is over by paying the tax or by avoiding tax. It is the job of the government to give the funding. Tell me how many universities get funds for research from UGC? Look at it. But no funding for research. Where is the funding for research? Research is like romance. It's a very, very expensive proposition. You need lots of money and muscle power to do research. So is for the mass. Next one, please. Look at the profile of students we get. I told you, India is a very unique country. No respectable business school will allow a guy to do his master's program in business administration if he had no work experience. Take it from me. But for us, it's BA. It is fully green with moss. Right? So, the kind of students you get. Now, you might ask a question, what about IIMs? IIMs, what do? We take a large number of 1.85 lakhs people, we do some churning and take the top one, thinking it's a queen, it could be flawed. We don't know what they are. But corporates believe that some of you students are the best. We don't question them because it suits us.
I'm being very candid with you. Like, what is the profile of students you get in a standalone business school somewhere on the way between Anakapalli and Visakhapatnam? What is the profile of students you expect? You may get students from, you know, Tripura and Northeast, thinking that there is something here. By the time they realize there is nothing here, the course is over. It takes time for them to understand. What are the profile of activities? Predominantly teaching. Very few institutions have a training opportunity. Please remember, it requires a different kind of a command of subject and orientation to make sense to your corporate life. Who had work experience? You can't fool around telling me Maslow's theory, Hitchberg, Masner, Snederman, Patricia King Smith was my classmate in America. Corporate guy will ask, sir, this guy is not working. He took retirement on the date of appointment. Tell me, how do I motivate? Straightforward question. Now, none of your motivation theories with a PowerPoint, with animations will help. Training, one advantage. Research, what research? There is no research at all. Consulting, very, very little and fine in terms of consulting. Right? Look at the profile of teachers. On 22 contingency table, you have a qualified and competent. Obviously. Not qualified, not competent. Make him an error. Why not? Right. Look at the candidate. Now, thanks to technology, if you can go to some interesting websites, there is MIT Open Classware, including the PowerPoint presentations of the professor, teaching notes, learning material, everything is available. In corporate, there is something called copyright. In academics, you don't have copyright, it is right to copy. Let's copy it. But our content, is it any time aligned to changing corporate demands? If corporates don't know, let them know through consulting. You tell them what are the changes. That's a consulting opportunity. Once you know what it is changed, then you can do it. It really happens. Right? Also remember, there is no point in leaving Delhi University. Tell me, what prevented that professor to add on those themes which are of a contemporary relevance?
Doesn't matter.
What are your observations? Even in fact. No, the point is.
I think it's not
correct.
That's
okay. Last 20 years,
it has been.
Sir, we have changed. What have you changed? We changed the content. We changed the content. Shall I speak about university system, sir? I'm from university. I'm not like one of those IIM who have fallen from America. No. I am 100% here. I have worked with 4 universities: Jawaharlal Nehru University, Usmania University, Bareilly University, Agra University. And I am very proud that I am a university. Whether you are proud or my colleagues are proud or not, doesn't matter. I am very proud. The point I am saying is, even if there is a change, tell me what is the change. You change according to the change in MIT. Boston, Cincinnati. Materials, are they dated or updated? Tell me, why are you forcing a student to understand a Maslow's motivation theory? You talked about content, materials. Not that there are no books by Indian authors, but most of the Indian authors' books are nothing but customized, made cheap. To an Indian student, you know this. You pick up a book on marketing management. It is nothing but straight away taken from Philip Kotler. You know, Charles becomes Chalamaya, Rams become Ramaya. The same bloody case. It is serving a purpose if a professor can say that I have written 5 books. You have to respect for his copying effort. Right? Is it theoretical or pragmatic? What is the point in telling a chap that you have to maintain 8 subsidy books and accountancy? We don't maintain account at all in India. What are we talking about?
Sir, I think.
We maintain more than one account, depending on which is the agency. Right? Method, is it teacher-centric or student-centric? Fundamental problem we have is, most of the business school education is teacher-centric. It is not student-centric. We don't want to realize what the student wants, which he may not know. Next, please. This is another toughest challenges for nascent business schools. Let me concentrate. Your location. ISB at one time was supposed to be, I don't know how many of you know this. When the committee said that you Hyderabad did not have connectivity, international connectivity, we wanted to ship it to Phuket. The reason being, state government of Andhra Pradesh was willing to put 16 lane road from Kuppam to Bangalore, and Bangalore had international connectivity.
Ambience becomes more important. Right? For a student, he is highly impressed by your website and your brochure. After he joins, you say this is a virtual organization. This is our vision and this is our mission. We are going to achieve all these things provided people like you come and get cheated by us. Obvious. Connectivity, what is this connectivity we are talking about? If you think of a campus, you cannot get a campus within the city. Unfortunately, in India, when we think of an education institution, we think of a huge campus. Majority of the first year budget goes in building the compound wall for the entire campus. Right, infrastructure, classrooms, library, computing. You know, several business schools tell me, we have a Wi-Fi in place. I ask them, how many hotspots you have? He doesn't understand what is a hotspot. I said, at least Bluetooth is in place. No, no, sir, I have bad tooth. We give all our students a laptop. Kiska Bhavka Paisa. Are you giving it free? No. It is by, you know, bulk buy. And what do the students, they do? Poor fellows, they say, first they learn how to play solitaire. No, no, fact of life. Solitaire, sir. Because it's always lonely on the top. He's preparing himself for a CEO's job by learning solitaire. Right? Now look at visible and credible faculty. I'll give you a solid example. Something which we have to learn from elsewhere in the world. Stephen Covey did not walk into classroom from the last 17 years. Stephen Covey, you heard his name? But the university retains him because he brings tremendous amount of reputation for that university. At one time, Stephen Covey's book was lying on the tables of secretaries, additional secretaries, joint secretaries, deputy secretaries in the Secretariat of Andhra Pradesh. It has become a big status symbol to put that book on the table. Right? Are they credible faculty? I'll tell you something interesting. Only in India you say, I'm from Usmania, I'm from IIM. If you look at typical American student, he says, I'm trained by John Kenneth Galbraith. They quote a teacher's name, not a university name. Please understand. Right? Now, biggest problem that you have is retention of faculty. Now, there are two ways of looking at it. IIM Lucknow. I'm talking about IIM Lucknow. There was a question in the parliament recently, which was a starred question. In the last 2 years, 29 out of 52 faculty members left IIM Lucknow. And our parliamentarians showed grave concern for it. A star question means a sponsored question. You know what's a sponsored question? Somebody paid to the parliamentarian to ask that question. Retention of faculty is a big problem. You know why? Those faculty you want them to leave, they will never leave. And those faculty you want them to stay, they will not stay. Fact of life. Credibility in systems and procedures. If you think All India Institute of Medical Sciences is respected as an organization, if IITs are respected, if IIMs are respected, only for one reason. Our methods may be crazy. Our methods may be hazy in terms of admission. But fact of the life, even cabinet secretary cannot succeed in getting a seat in IIT and IIM through recommendation. Evidence. None of the IIM directors could succeed in pushing their children into IIMs. I'm not joking. Check up the data. You can check up the data. Prakash Apte's son has studied in IIT Kharagpur, my present director's son. So even director cannot. So it is the credibility that matters in systems and procedures. Industry and corporate support. I firmly believe we don't get any support in industry, from industry and corporate. We don't get. I told you their job is over by paying tax or by appearing to have paid the tax. The biggest problem that we have is that since we don't experience students, we have to give them a summer project. Summer project is part of an academic program. The objective of a summer job in US is to help the guy unlearn what he learned so far in the corporate world. The primary purpose of a summer project in India is let him experience an entity called boss. Because he never saw an animal called boss. Right? Final placements. Well, there is no final word about it. Fact of the life, every institution, in its own creative ways, claims to have placement. Let me tell you, for a very long time in this country, IIMs, when all students were not placed, there was a mechanism in place. Those people who could not get placed, no, they will give a letter that they are opting out of placements. If there is no lady available to get married to me, I declare through a gadget notification, I decided to be a bachelor. Look at this. This is built on what Guru Krishnamurti said. You can see the commonalities. Can we develop competence that is of a demonstrable ability to apply knowledge and skills? A business school is supposed to do this. Those sets of competencies that can be demonstrated. Please understand. Demonstrable ability is something which corporate guys look at. Can I smile when I'm boiling inside? That's a fact of life. I feel like kicking the customer, but can I tell him that you're the king? Right? Important thing is, am I able to get along with people? Or am I good at sitting on the people? Right? Compatibility. Character is that component of an individual which does not undergo change overnight. There is no situational changes in behavior. If I'm an idiot, if I'm a teetotaler, and I will be a teetotaler. If somebody tells me we'll give you Rajya Sabha nomination, 120 milli chata. Whether you take 120 milli or 1.5 liter scotch bottle or one drop, you are not a teetotaler. Right? Conviction, courage, composure. My friends in corporate, they asked me, "Hey, up, kya karte hain do saal mein aapka students ko?" I said, very simple. We build confidence to fool around professionally. When you commit a mistake confidently, you are rarely caught. You try this. If there is a helmet rule in Hyderabad, you drive without helmet. Confidently, you will not be stopped. अगर इस तरह खुद देखे तो वो अंदर घुस जाएगा. टिपिकल पुलिस कल्चर, राइट? केयर, कंपैशन एंड कंसर्न. मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंटली, प्रीतम हैज मेंशन्ड दिस एज अ पासिंग पॉइंट, कैन वी डेवलप कॉन्टेक्चुअल सेंसिटिविटी डिस्पाइट द सिमिलैरिटीज, कैन आई सी द सिचुएशंस टू बी रिलेटेड. नेक्स्ट, दिस इज आई वांटेड टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट. नाउ वी टॉक्ड अबाउट डिवाइडेड इंडिया, आई वॉन्ट अनडिवाइडेड बिजनेस स्कूल्स इन इंडिया. Right? Can you form into forums to evolve? Credible admission procedures. Why do you want to go to IIMs and stand in the queue and say that, "Sir, please allow me to use your canteen"? Pay 95,000 rupees, I think it's the present fee. 1.8 lakh? 1.8 lakh they have to pay. No, to use CAT scores. To use CAT scores. No.
95.
These are all the models which Ravi Kumar and others have developed today. Very, very simple. You have to first pay a fee, then we'll come and assess your process. That means we'll come and see your institution.
Right.
That is what is called assessment. Maybe you put me makes a difference. Right? Now, then we'll say, okay, it's a good school. There's a heavy political manipulation. Then what happens is, you allow, but incidentally you don't get the data about all the 1.8 lakhs of students have written. You get the data about those applicants to your school. So file the care. You're taking the best out of the worst. Right? Please think of faculty norms of recruitment and development. There's a heavy poaching going on in faculty. From one institute to another institute to another institution. Don't blame MBA graduates, blame MBA professors first. I tell two things. One is, people to be blamed in this country are MBA professors. Second thing, my friends in HR. HR fellows in industry tell the potential candidate, "Hey, you should be loyal to company, yeah? You should stay for at least for 2 years. And this evening, this guy jumped from Sachem to Bipo." So I tell them, my HR colleagues need what is called a digital card. Only name is standard. All other things keep changing. Right? Please form into a forum and evolve faculty norms. Have thugs, gentlemen. You know, thugs are very honest. You know that? You know, thugs are very honest. A thief who has a jurisdiction of Chikkanpalli will not go and steal from Nambali. Why don't you have the dentist? Right? Faculty norms. Second thing of recruitment and development. Several business schools in budgetary allocations, there is nothing called faculty development. Actually, these business schools follow what is called case method. I'll tell you what is case method in business schools. Not teaching method. Case by case. If I like Mishraji, I will send him to America under faculty development. I don't like him. No, you can't go even to Anagapati. Suppose he says, my paper is accepted. Oh, many papers are accepted. Okay, cold water, right? Pooled placements. Why can't you think of pooled placements? Naukri.com can have. Hindu can do. Hindu newspaper, nothing to do with business. They have a pooled placements. You know what's pooled placements? You know, Mela. Let half a dozen companies come and you arrange the students and let them pick them. Pooled industry corporate interface. Well, collaborative efforts. No, unfortunately, like it, don't like it. Brahmanatvam, Bhinnatvam. Yachako, Yachako, Setu. Business school or Setu. The fact of life. IP, though it existed in Usmani University, it did not have anything with Usmani University Management Department, am I right? You are in the same location. No, you interact. I'm not saying that. That's because of several reasons. Either you are forced to interact or they force themselves on you. No, I'm not joking. You have a central university. This is the first program. And I was very much hot about it. I told Dr. Venkatramana, Venkatramana, let's make an attempt. You make an attempt. If Mishraji does not come, we'll give him the blame. I take one step forward. If Mishraji stands there, the distance is reduced, isn't it? If Mishraji also comes one step forward, we are slightly closer. Right? Collaborative efforts for joint research programs. I'll give you a simple example. Pick up any international journal. You will find large number of people as authors. At times, there will be 20 authors, 16 authors, 12 authors. You take any typical Indian researcher, it's Avak Nivanjan. I'm all alone. How many joint publications we have? I'm saying, culturally we have a problem. We don't want to join hands. Right? Think of collaborative efforts in terms of joint research programs. If two, three business schools pool their faculty resource, and apply, and AICT is in a very, very peculiar position. They have so much of money, they don't know what to do. Funding is abundant. Only thing, there is nobody asking. Vishwajit was mentioning to you, hey, let a professor become rich in the name of research. I have no problem. It happens in sciences. You know this, any science project proposal will have the following. Air conditioners, refrigerators. Anybody in the science background? I used to have a guy called Bhimasankar University, Usmani University. Whenever I wanted to travel, he says, take this vehicle and go. It's a huge imported vehicle. It's supposed to test some minerals and something. You know? It contains the equipment. But most of the trips are made between the department and other places. Fine. What is wrong in this country when a politician becomes rich? Why can't a professor become rich? Let him make some money, let him also do some research. Right? Why can't you think of doing some common, you know, on a collaborative efforts, workshops, seminars, and publications? Next one, please. That is the last. What my whole purpose of telling you is, there is no point in blindly aping IIMs. Take it granted for me. Even if you succeed, they will say, you are also like IIM. They say, you are better than IIM. One guy says, he's better than IIM. Only he says. Right? There is no point in trying to be a better IAM. Fact of the life is, IAMs are highly, you know, there is something called Dharjam IAM. Highly patternized. The whole society pounced on Murali Manohar Joshi because he tried to finger something in IITs and IAMs, that's all. It's a motherhood statement. So forget about IAMs. You can learn many things from IAM so that you don't repeat the same mistakes. IAMs are excellent role models. right? You can see what they're trying to do and they fail. For example, what they have miserably failed is in doing appraisal of the faculty. This counting of beans, you know, 6 creditors, 10 creditors, all of them are only on paper. The strength of a management school like IIM is you have people who are committed to themselves. Fact of life. They are in teaching profession precisely because they enjoy being in teaching profession. Like it, don't like it. Like, and I coach a friend of mine who is a very popular face on ETV2. He recently contested graduate council, lost miserably, that's a different story. Right? This person is graduated from London School of Economics. And I told him, why don't you? So IIM was willing to make an offer to him. He told me, boss, there's not much money being a professor. Then I said, you choose politics. He has chosen politics. Because in politics, there is no retirement. There is no entry requirements. There is no assessment. What? So if you want to become rich, if any one of your colleagues says that paisa nahi hai, you tell them, listen, paisa nahi hai. But actually, if you calculate, for the number of hours you teach, and the total salary you get, I think you are better paid than Nandan Nilekar. Thank you so much.
Well, I would like to go into the remaining issues later.
RH3, Professor Sai Kumar, Professor Ravi Kumar, Professor R.K. Mishra, Professor Mansula Reddy, Dr. Chetan, and our correspondent, Mr. V. Siddhari. I am the director of this institute. I am qualified and competent. I just wanted to make sure that I'm not in this part because I'm not qualified at all, not competent. I'm both, in a positive way. This afternoon, I just wanted to share with you a little bit about what our institution is. Not just what our institution is about, but also about the fact what kind of challenges we are facing as an affiliated institution. The academic challenges of affiliated colleges, this is what I wanted to present today. And I hope at least some of the AICTE members are still around here, because I'm referring this to mostly to those AICTE members who are present here, and I just wanted to make sure we are heard as affiliated institutions. This is a little bit about me. Since nobody has introduced, I'm a Nizam College product, Usmani University. I've obtained my master's in business administration and computer information science at Saint Andrews Campus University. I work for Burlington Northern Secondary Railway, operations research and planning at General Foundation, and I was a consultant for two multinationals, Northern Telecom and Sprint. And I'm continuing the advisor for executive vice president to another global entity, Enterprise Without Borders. Right now, I'm working with St. Anthony's Community College as director. We strive to provide the best education to our students with an aim to promote superior managers to serve the needs of the current multinational environment. The current multinational environment requires us to produce candidates who are competent, not only competent, but also team builders who can fill into the roles of the multinational managers. In that scenario, what is our role? We want to impart value-added education, but we have challenges. We have demographic challenges because of the fact that our students are mostly from regions, other regions than the urban areas. The mushrooming colleges on the outskirts. We have many, many students coming out of these colleges. And the challenges to students and faculty, distance and time, because of the fact that they are placed outside the city limits. they have their own challenges to reach the colleges. And by the time they come, most of the students are tired, most of the faculty wants to sleep. No, I don't mean that. Not in our college. How did it enter? So we have some issues that are related to imparting value-added education. Consistent attendance is a key problem we are facing, and how do we balance that equation is a challenge for us too. How do we balance the equation? We have to have certain facilities by which they will not make any attempts to miss the classes or so. Because most of the students who are coming from outside the Darabin areas, they go out on vacation for holidays and they stay home for 2 or 3 days. They don't want to come back the next day because mom and dad, they don't want, or they want to come and have a good time somewhere. And also because of the fact that they come from some of these underprivileged areas, we face the challenges to the medium of instruction. If I go there and lecture them at this speed, they will have a serious problem. Because of the fact that they are not able to comprehend at a level where some of these institutions like IIMs and B schools can, students can. Because of the preeminence of those B schools, we are not able to meet the challenges we face because of the student body, the component of the students in each of the areas. Our efforts to equalize the scale, how are we planning on equalizing the scales? Because we are actually operating not in a plane. It is tilted towards one or the other. So we want to equalize that by providing additional teaching methods to the students who are not able to comprehend at that level where the master's program requires. Challenges to qualitative approach for affiliated colleges, that is integrated internal assessments and administrative issues. We had somebody come in and administer some assessment tests the other day because we wanted to make sure the students who are participating or the students who are preparing for the examinations are.
Professor Seaman, Sudhan Reddy garu, to offer his remarks.
Yeah, affectionately he's called as CMR. He was former professor in the Department of Business Management, Usman University. Presently, he is the secretary and correspondent of CVR College of Engineering. Founder of CVR College of Engineering. Known to have created benchmarks in the administration of the engineering colleges. And also, I would like to tell you in this context that he has MBA department, which he cherishes to nurture, mentor, and monitor. And we are proud to say that we are all his cheeras.
So, my friends of the dais and of the dais, we started MBA the current year at our CVR College of Engineering, which is into sixth year. The third batch of B.Tech students are passing out in the next month. In the last 6 years, we have done reasonably well. I would initially tell you about the problems of engineering colleges having MBA program. Because this is something peculiar to us. You have MBA programs under the university system, you have MBA programs as autonomous system or PGDBM, and you have MBA program in engineering colleges. Between the fees paid by a B.Tech student on one side and MBA and MSc student on the other side. The ASD regulations do not provide different rules for the faculty ratio, that is 1:15, and also class intake being 60 in both the cases, MCR, MBA or B.Tech, 60 is the class intake ratio of teachers is 1 to 15. Cadet ratio is 1:2:6, both for BTEC, MBA, MCA. Salaries are same. Now it is for the, only one university representative is here. And Sai Kumar is an university not representative. Another representative is central government representative sitting here, Ravara. Please tell us, how do we pay salaries to our teachers of MBA and MCA with, you know, fee being collected is much less than what we are collecting from BTEC students. Are we justified in giving a lower fees for MBA and MCA when you are insisting for the same students' academic ratio, same academic cadre ratio, same salaries for MCA and MBA teachers? This is one problem that is to be addressed by the government, both Ramana's government and also our RSS government, state and central government. They have to answer this problem. This is the problem which we, an engineering college, face. Now let me talk about the problems at a different level. Well, we have Professor Ramakrishna Sher. What is his name? Ramakumar Sharmaji. Mishraji. Ramakumar Mishraji. Nobody knows his name, but at least I know his name. So he runs a diploma program with an intake of 120 with CAT scores. It's a well accepted program in the city as compared to many other diploma programs, like one in Medchal, one in Maritpalli, one in Kachagoda station. Like that, there are many other diploma programs. His program is rated well as one of the best diploma programs. So we have a diploma program. We have a program run by university, and we have a program run by an affiliated college. Most affiliated college coming under either standalone or coming under the engineering college pattern. Now look at, you know, the type of student that joined the diploma program. And look at the type of student that joined the MBA program. I used to consider the Department of Business Management of Osmanian City as a very great institution, and its MBA program is one of the best programs next to IIM Bangalore in the 80s and 90s. Not realizing that Osmania's MBA program was not great. It was not great. Compared to BIM, Bharadasan Institute of Management, an institute which has only just 5 teachers, of them 2 professors, 3 non-professors, they are not greatly known. Whereas the Department of Business Management of Osmania City had 33 on the budget, 24 on the rolls. They more than 8 professors, more than 8 or so readers, and equal number of lecturers. Usmania having 24 teachers was not great when compared to BIM. I knew it only when I went to BIM 1999 as an AICT expert. It is located in BHC at Trichy, far away from the university. Salaries of the teachers are paid by the university, Bharadasan University. It has no control on the MBA program of BIM. There was a director called Jay Shankaran, another professor, and 3 other teachers. That's only 5. And the intake was 60. And Usmania had 60 intake in 2 sections, 30 each. But there, 60 was one intake. And most of the faculty was coming from Chennai by flight, arriving at Trichy Airport. From there, they were taken to BHL by car. And the jobs that the 60 students of BIM were getting were much superior, much higher compared to what Usmania DBM was getting. So are we to go by the faculty that we have at DBM Usmania? 24. I think even today we have about 24. Only 5 at BIM. So I realized very late in my career as a teacher, after 37 long years, I realized institutions are known because of the students, not because of the teachers. BIM was having admissions from any part of this country. Usmania can give admission to only Telanganites. Usmania can give admissions to offer them from BC, SC, ST, of course, no regrets for that. And also giving admission to Telugu medium students as a reservation, 20%. And then reservation for women, but not. Then we have reservation for sports, NCC, physically disabled, what not, everything in the 60 seats. But there is no such reservation for anybody at BIM, for the Institute of Management, all the 60 coming from every part of this country. There was a heterogeneous group that our Misraji has. Of course, he's not totally Indian, mostly South, partly East, that's what I understand from IP. Suppose if you could get people from North, West and Central, IP can become no way inferior to IIM Bangalore. So what we need is heterogeneous group with ISET and admissions to all our MBA programs in Andhra Pradesh. We have in MC and MBA must be having not less than 45,000 seats, 45,000 seats. All these seats reserved to local people. Again, we have divided Andhra Pradesh into three groups, Telangana, Andhra, Rayalaseema, reservations for various communities, various women and all the such reservations. What type of people do we get? We have people who have come through Telugu medium. Can they understand MBA that when they have, no, of the 60 students we have in our first, of course we have only MBA first year. 8 or 9 are Telugu medium. Hardly 4 or 5 have known that there is a business. About 8 or 9 of them, their parents, first time they have become businessmen. Their parents have become, father has become businessmen for the first time. So 52 students have come from backgrounds where there is no business absolutely. No water business. And nearly 10 students haven't studied English medium. And the students join a college to do their MBA because their parents want that they should do MBA. Simple logic that. So what we need today is heterogeneity. All these MBA should be removed from the university system. ANU will not have an MBA college affiliated to it, Usmania will not have. You remove all these colleges, make them autonomous. What is going to be the loss? Misraji, we lost? Why can't we recommend to AICT, make all the MBA colleges in this country as autonomous. Let them make admissions. Let me get students from Haryana, from Punjab, from Rajasthan, from Madhya Pradesh. Why should not I get students from there? Let my students from Telangana go to any part of India. It is heterogeneity that pays you, not homogeneity. That homogeneous group doesn't pay you at all. We have already created a dual system in management education. It's not done in MCA, it's not done in engineering. In engineering and MCA, you cannot offer a course unless it is approved by AICTE, unless they are affiliated to a university. BTech should be under a university. MCA should be under university. Maybe ICFA is conducting some BTEC program, it will not have any charm. It may conduct MCA program, no charm absolutely. Not many people would be interested in ICFA, MCA, or BTEC. But in the case of MBA, we have a different system in this country. We have the diploma program, we have the MBA program. Why this dualism? Why this dual system? Why can't we convert all these MBA programs into diploma only? Let them give their degree. Heavens are not going to fall. Our MBA education will not come down. What is that I can offer salary to my teacher at CBR? 18,000, 20,000, which is compares very well with Bhadruka. Right? Teachers in CBR, they are paid on par with Bhadruka, which is the best institute next to the Department of Business Management. All through, Bhadruka has been number two next to the Department of Business Management under Usmani. But JNU is different. So the salaries of our teachers at CBR are on par with Bhadruka, the best. And we are only in the first year. We are in the first year of our MBA program. But these are nothing compared to the salaries that we pay to our engineering teachers. 5 years later, an engineering college teacher gets 25,000 to 30,000. MBA teacher cannot get that. How can he afford to pay? Because the fee that we receive is much less. Well, friends, you know, I have posed some problems. So we need some solutions. We cannot afford to pay more. If I want to pay more, I must run a diploma program like what Ms. Raji is running. Diploma program, the college, the lower side 60,000, the higher side is about 1,20,000 per year. We carry 30,000, 31,000. Where is 31,000 per year? Where is 1,50,000 per year? I don't know what is being charged by IP today per year. What is the fee, sir?
We're going to charge 3 lakhs per year from
next 3 lakhs.
From next year.
Yeah, we are likely to charge 3 lakhs, we are likely to charge 60,000.
The best fee is 9 lakhs per year in many institutions.
No, let us just look at the institution which is represented here and the MBA program that we have in Andhra Pradesh.
I mean, rating is superior to Bhaktivinoda.
Yes, superior to?
Bhaktivinoda.
Good.
We are superior to Bhaktivinoda. Research, we are clubbed with IIM Bangalore and IIM Ahmedabad. IP is clubbed with IIM Ahmedabad and Bangalore. I give you intellectual capital.
Good. That is the reason why.
Anish and Sai, you are my friends.
Good.
It's a pleasure to be here this afternoon. After a long time coming back home. After leaving Usmani University, working for some time in industry and abroad. After 20 years, I came back to Hyderabad to see what is happening in business schools. I had an opportunity to address not less than 50-60 business schools and engineering colleges these days. Whoever invited me, I went there to address. Because I want to give back to the society and the students and the faculty. It's a sad state of affairs. I've been listening since morning, everybody. Things have not that best. Looking from the point of view of the business schools, universities, private institutions especially, and then the faculty, and the students, and the management. These are the important actors in any business school. Look at the governance of these schools. Who is heading these boards of these business schools? Is it a politician or a businessman or an academician? Or who is heading? It is very difficult to appreciate what kind of things are happening at the helm of the affairs. You don't find much professionalism in the boards. That is the reason morning some speakers were saying ethical governance and governance. Governance is very poor. There are no boards functioning at all. There is no expertise. There are no qualified people in the board. sometimes uneducated people are the chairman of business school. What he will contribute to the board? I have seen this. Politician is a unemployed politician is a board chairman. Or a petty business fellow is having black money, he started a business school. I don't have to, you are aware about it. This is my observation after so many years coming back to Hyderabad. Top management is in a poor state of affairs. Therefore, I would suggest this august body to take up immediately the statistical analysis of all the institutions that have been created under the AICT in Andhra Pradesh at least to start with, and bring out the whole statistical data afore to this kind of meetings and share with people so that you know governance issue is a very important issue today that should be noted and recommended to AICT if possible for funding etc. This is to be, there should be some qualification, some expertise in the board, some qualified person should be there, some kind of our industrial expert who can help the these business schools to make it is more practical. They are merely treated as profit making islands of profit making. You talk to any secretary of this institute, they never care the faculty, they never care the, practically I am telling, in one of the selection committee of the city, an applicant came and the secretary is offering 6,000 rupees, an MBA with 1 year experience, having wife and child, very painful. He used a filthy language saying that he will come for that money only, he said. Please don't say like that, he's a teacher, you can't afford to talk like that. That person, I told him, it's very painful affair. These are realities and this is an issue. I would suggest you to please make note of this. Faculty is another gray area. Competency of the faculty is very, very pathetic sometimes. What they have studied and they're just taking it to the classroom, sharing with the students. Not much concern for the student and understanding the student profile as such. Hence, there is a big problem here. So many business schools have come up, so many private institutions have come up. So many IIMs are already there. Now, nobody wants to start a business school for teachers. How many are there? ICFA has started. There are 12 students in that. Imagine. That's also not functioning well. So teachers, there is a dearth of teachers. There is a need for what is called academy. Morning, Mr. Swami was mentioning. Some kind of academy should be initiated by the government or the private sector itself. One who can come forward and then do it. Because teachers have to be grown, especially younger teachers. So that is one area, gray area, and problem area, I think, as a challenge before all of us. Students, as I told you, you know, profile of the students. I appreciate the idea which my colleague, former colleague, Mr. C. M. Reddy was mentioning. Heterogeneous, yes, I worked in Delhi as the director of business school. Definitely, a cosmopolitan faculty is an asset to the institution. Never groom a particular caste or region. It won't help much in the long run. In the short run, one may take advantage of the that situation, but in the long run, is the cosmopolitan thing that helps in the growth of the institution from the point of view of the institution. From the point of individual, it's okay. I have nothing to say on that. But from the point of view of institution, it makes a lot of difference. And I have seen there will be less politics in the business schools, if you have cosmopolitan area, because nobody becomes, no group becomes powerful there. This is my experience. I work in Delhi as director of business school in private sector. So that also one should keep in mind. You should not put restrictions that it should be taken, but still human weakness, you know, it happens. The profile of students, you know, basically what I have seen, the skill area of these students in business schools, private institutions as well as university colleges is very good. The other day, I have addressed a faculty of 120 people in Jilmatla, there's one private sector group, faculty members.
Now I would like to invite Sri Dr. Sai Kumar